Hey guys, what's going on? It's Dokkan here, and today we're going to be going over the quick update that came out to the global side of things on top of the event that was reopened, which is the Galactic Crisis Super Guide in the Galaxy.
Hey guys, if you're enjoying the content that I provide here on my channel, don't forget to hit that like button, and also don't forget to subscribe and enable notifications, that way you get the most recent and up-to-date information about Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle delivered directly to you. Thank you, enjoy the video, and have a great day.
Now, real quick, the only real new thing that's happened is that Grandpa Gohan is finally getting his Dokkan Awakening. That's pretty cool. Thanks again to Zahal for making these doing this data mining for us. There are two translated cards, the Super Saiyan 4 Goku, the Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta. Apparently, they're passives, which mean that it can dodge the attack or something like that, which is supposed to be like disable the enemy super. It translates to seal the enemy super attack. It shouldn't actually mean sealing their attack. But it's essentially just misleading. So we will find out exactly how they're going to translate it in the future once it actually gets released. The Tree of Might will return on 619. Grandpa Gohan's going to be on 619. And right now, the strongest guy in the galaxy returns, which is the Boujack and Super Saiyan Kid Gohan event, or Teen Gohan event. Adolescent event? The orb event dates are back to normal, by the way. Means you don't get the double rates or anything like that. But let's go ahead and start talking about the Galactic Crisis and Super Guy in the Unit Galaxy. So, yeah, really horrible title, first off. I didn't ever get to cover this because this was back, like, when this game first came out. I remember when this first came out. It was in a really difficult event, but it was a little bit more difficult when you got towards the end. I remember using Sensu Beans and everything on the last levels. this is pretty cool. So, essentially, with today's meta, you could just blast right through it. But I'm just going to go ahead and talk about each level real quick, because I figure it warrants a little overview. And we're going to talk about where the medals are located, because we're going to talk about the Gohan that's farmable here and his Dokkan Awakening to Super Saiyan. So, real quick, level 1, World Tournament Time, you go up against an Agility Tien. Level 2, the worst match ever. You go up against both a strength and a physical opponent. The strength one is Yamcha, and the boss is a physical Piccolo. Level 3, the finals commence. You go up against an Agility Zangya. Now, this is where you get your Zangya medals on Z-Hard. She drops 0 to 3 medals at a 70% drop rate. That's where you're going to find hers. By the way, I'm going to leave a link to the wiki down in the description below. If I forget, let me know. Sometimes I forget. But I'll put that down in the description below so that way you guys can actually follow this so you don't have to keep on rewatching the same parts of the video. Level 4, Mysterious Galactic Warrior. This is where you get your Gokua medals. Same thing as the Zangya Z-Hard, 70% drop rate, 0 to 3. He's a tech type. Level 5, the seal is lifted. You go up here against Bido. You face off against the physical, agility, and intelligence character. And that is the physical Bido, the agility Zangya, and the intelligence Bujin. This is where the Bido medals are have 70% drop rate, 0 to 3 on Z-Hard. Level 6, Vicious Galactic Warrior. Again, you go up against multiple opponents, Strength Boujack, then Physical, Intelligence, and Agility again. You drop Bujin medals here as a 70% from 0 to 3, anywhere from 0 to 3 of them. Level 7, Formidable Boujack. You go up against Base Form, Strength Boujack. Boujack medals are dropped here at 60% rate, 0 to 3 of them drop per turn. Level 8, Extreme Peril. Z-Hard, you go up against your first round of Agility, Physical, Intelligence, and then the second round is going to be Strength, Agility, Intelligence, and Physical. So make sure you have your AoE units available just to blow through this round if you have them. This round can drop, well, the first one can drop, Zangya, a Bido, and a Bujin medal, 10% drop rate, 0 to 2 of each, and then the second one is 5% of the Gokua and the Boujack medals. You could drop anywhere from 0 to 2 of them. I wouldn't recommend running that level for your metal grind. You could go through any of the others for that. Level 9, Serious Fight. This is where you go up against the full-powered Boujack. It's a strength type. This one also, you could farm the Grand Plan Gohan Youth card. He has a 30% drop rate. You drop any up to only one per fight. So that's that. And you have a 60% drop rate for his medals between 0 to 3 of them on Z-Hard. Now, you're going to want to grind those cards out because they do have a Dokkan Awakening Super Saiyan form. But before we get to that, let's go ahead and talk about the level 10 greatest challenge. This is, you go up against Hercule. He's an intelligence unit. Super intelligence, you go up and you get 100,000 Zenny for defeating him. So, since we're all strapped for cash, 100,000 zenny is not too hard, and since it's not too bad, and since this guy is really super easy to beat, you can go ahead and grind that level out for zenny. It's going to be available. But let's go ahead and talk about the Gohan real quick. So, the Grand Plan Gohan Youth. I'm not going to go over any of the stats in this video whatsoever. We're just going to talk about the usefulness here. He Dokkan awakens with medals from the event. You're going to need 7 Zangya, you need 7 Gokua, 7 Bido, 7 Bujin, and 7 Boujack medals. Now, you can get him up to Super Titanium Dokkan Awaken if you want. Back in the day, he Dokkan Awakens into Resolute Valor Super Saiyan Gohan Youth. Back in the day, this card was actually good. When he first came out, his attack plus 30% actually made him hit hard. I remember running him. Yeah, we used to run SRs on the in the game back in the day. He was definitely on my physical team for a very long time. I forgot when I ended up finally taking him off, but... Yeah, remember, I don't know if all you OGs will remember that. When you Z-Awaken him to SSR, he is actually farmable and feedable. You could feed him into 4 different cards. The first one being the Gentle Hearted Warrior Super Saiyan Gohan Youth. Now this one is available for, I guess, when you start playing the game, you get to summon on a character if you get him, or you can purchase him from the Baba Shop. I don't know if you would want to do that. You can if you would like to. There's really no reason to, in my opinion, to actually feed him into here, but you know what, you could do it. The next one would be the Enraged at Evil Super Saiyan Gohan Youth. This was the one that was available from the World Tournament. This is a really good support unit. He doesn't have anything that really buffs his own attack, but it has supreme damage, so you could technically raise him up if you want. I know when I got mine, I fed all 4 Dupads in. I'm going to probably try to get him up to Super Attack 10, just because I can. I'll probably end up running him on a super team once in a while just for fun. But yeah, he is someone you can get to Super Tech 10. If this is one of your best cards that you have, then go for it. The next one is going to be the OG Super Saiyan Gohan, successor of the strongest Super Saiyan Gohan Youth. This is the old school intelligence one. He does have a Dokkan Awakening, so you would want to make sure you do not Dokkan Awaken him before you feed those Gohans in, the Resolute Valor Gohans into him. Extreme damage, but he Dokkan Awakens. If you get him up to Super Attack 10, he does supreme damage, and his passive skill gives him key plus 4 attack plus 2500 when HP is 50% or above. So it's still not an amazing card, but you can get up to Super Attack 10 without a problem. Though, the one I would recommend waiting for, though it's very difficult to get, I would keep him on standby, maybe about 20 to 25 of them, if you want to go through that grind. The Fateful Day Super Saiyan Gohan Youth, that is the L or Gohan card. If you want to get up to Super Tech 10 without using Elder Kai's, I would recommend going to the Galactic Crisis Super Guy event, farming up at least 20 to 25 Grand Plan Gohan Youths, Dokkan Awakening into Resolute Valor Gohans, and then just sitting on them Z-Awakened until the Fateful Day Super Saiyan Gohan Youth, if you get him. Because then you don't have to worry about using Elder Kai's on him if you want to go through that grind. Again, it's going to be a pain in the butt because his Dokkan Awakening, he's 7 of each metal, and you're going to have to grind 7 of each medal for 20 to 25. That's just ridiculous. That's what, 140 medals you're going to need? I don't know. I don't know if I would want to 140 to 180 medals. I don't know if you want to go through that, but you can. And that's what this video is here for, to let you know that it's possible. Now, real quick, we're going to go ahead and talk about the Boujack. Now, the Boujack does not have a farmable unit from this event. He is summonable from all summons. He's an SR unit that can be dropped. If you get him, you can make the choice. You could either, if you have yours at SA10 and you Dokkan Awaken him, he requires 12 of each metal to Dokkan Awaken except for his own. So he requires 12 Zangya, 12 Gokua, 12 Bido, 12 Bujin, and 12 Gohan medals. He will Dokkan Awaken into full power Boujack, the full strength Tremor full power Boujack. So that's a little bit of a grind to get him to Dokkan Awaken. He's not farmable. So when you Dokkan Awaken him here, that's where he is. You might want to consider getting Super Deck 10 just because, you know, if you want to have him for collective purposes. He himself on the JP side does Dokkan Awaken with 12 of his own Boujack medals. He Dokkan Awakens into shockingly powerful energy, full power Boujack. Again, he's still not really a useful card, but if you want to prep just so that way you can grind out 12 Boujack medals if you're not into grinding out to feed into the super attacks. If you're just like, you know what, I'll just use the Elder Kai's and do that, you know, go ahead and do that. Anyway, when you Dokkan Awaken him to his first full power Boujack form, he can feed into the full power Boujack agility card, the Galactic Annihilation card. This card is still not amazing, He is an agility leader. Not an agility leader. He is an agility card who doesn't really do that much. He does have his own Dokkan Awakening as well, which requires the 12 Boujack Medals as well. So if you really want to save up, just for the hell of it, go ahead and get 24 Boujack Medals from this event, so that way you could Dokkan Awaken both your strength and your agility one if they come to the global side the way that JP did. His agility one, though, is kind of actually worth it because he now does supreme damage and greatly lowers defense, and he gives himself attack plus 90% at the start of the turn, so he's really not that bad to run on an Android 17 led team or Super 17 led team, the extreme agility type, because he gets that attack plus 90% at the start of the turn with supreme damage. I mean, yeah, it's not immense, but it's not a horrible, you know, passive at all. And his link skills, he has big bad bosses, though the others are kind of outdated. Thirst for Conquest can be useful depending on who you're running. Now, I did leave one out. You could actually feed the base form SR Boujack into the Oppressive Tyrant Boujack. That's the tech type. You don't need to Dokkan Awaken him for that. You could just keep the SRs, awaken it to SSR, and then you can feed it into the Oppressive Tyrant Boujack. This one is the one that's available from the Baba Shop. I don't know why you would do that. He has extreme damage modifier. His super attack is 50% when performing a super attack. He's not amazing in it by any means. I guess we would have to wait to find out who the tech extreme lead is before I could say he's useful or not, to see if he links well with them. But even so, an extreme damage modifier, you're not going to really want to run him anyway. But yeah, that's it, guys. That was a full overview of the event and who feeds into who at this time in the game. It is currently June 14th, so if you're watching this in a year from now and things have changed, well, I will probably do an updated video on it at that time. But thanks, hit that sub button if you're new here, and I'll catch you in the next video.